have started that Christmas season. So we have a picture of joy. If you would have had a bulletin, you would have that picture of joy. You have it up there. That's what we try to stir up inside of ourselves during this Christmas season. The confession and absolution are a little bit different this today. We're going to do it by singing a song with the words have been rewritten to acknowledge our sins and acknowledge the forgiveness that we have in Christ. The song will be sung to the tune, I Heard the Bells. So we do things a little bit different sometimes. That's one of the little things that are different today. May the Lord bless our worship. Stand. Remembering our baptism, we begin in the name of the Father of Jesus and ours, in the name of the Son who took on human flesh at Christmas to be our Savior, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, the instrument of Jesus' birth and our rebirth.
Amen. Amen.
Almighty and merciful God, we thank you for sending your Son to become human like us, so that we might become your children. Make us who trust in Jesus to be more and more like him, For he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first lesson for this first Sunday after Christmas and the commemoration of St. John, Apostle and Evangelist, is written in Revelation chapter 1, verses 1 to 6. The revelation from Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants what soon must take place. He made it known by sending his angels to his servant John, who testified to everything that he saw. That is, the word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ. Blessed is the one who reads aloud the words of this prophecy, and blessed are those who hear it and take it to heart what is written in it, because the time is near. John, to the seven churches in the province of Asia. Grace and peace to you from him who is, and who was, and who is to come, and from the seven spirits before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, and has made us to be a kingdom and priests to serve his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second lesson is the first epistle of John, chapter 1, beginning at the first verse. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked at and our hands have touched, this we proclaim concerning the word of life. The life appeared, we have seen it and testify to it, and we proclaim to you the eternal life which was with the Father and has appeared to us. We proclaim to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us, and our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We write this to make our joy complete. This is the message that we have heard from him and declare to you. God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have fellowship with him and yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live out the truth. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, purifies us from all sin. If we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just, and will forgive us our sins, and purify us from all unrighteousness. If we claim we have not sinned, we make him out to be a liar, and his word is not in us. My dear children, I write this to you so that you will not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only for ours, but also for the sins of the whole world. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the second chapter, verses 22 to 40.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the time came for the purification rites required by the law of Moses, Joseph and Mary took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male is to be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer a sacrifice in keeping with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon. He was a righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all nations, a light for the revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel." The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Penuel of the tribe of Asher. She was very old. She had lived with her husband 7 years after marriage, and then was a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped night and day, fasting and praying. Coming up to them at that very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. When Joseph and Mary had done everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their town of Nazareth, and the child grew and became strong. He was filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was on him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We now make confession of our faith, speaking these words. I believe in God, the creator of all things, seen and unseen, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, announced by the angels, worshipped by the shepherds, adored by the Magi, called from Egypt, raised in Nazareth, died on the cross, rose from the grave, all of this in fulfillment of the messianic prophecies. He went victoriously to hell and to heaven. He will come again as judge of all. I believe in the Holy Spirit, giver of life in Mary's womb and in our hearts. Amen.
Thank you. The bells are ringing, people are singing. Angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger. Prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. The bells are ringing, people are singing. Angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger. Prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. Behold the gift of salvation, a light for all to see, revealing all God's glory, Emmanuel is he. Behold the gift of salvation, in Christ the promised one, shining through the darkness, Jesus Christ has come. The bells are ringing, people are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger, prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. The bells are ringing, people are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. There in a manger, he was no stranger, prophesied, now alive, Jesus is born. Glory to the King, Lord of everything, Christ has finally come. Glory to the King, let the people sing, hallelujah. People are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. Come and receive him, you can believe him, glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. The bells are ringing, people are singing, angels say with joy, Jesus is born. Come and receive him, you can believe him, glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. Glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. Glorified, still alive, Jesus is Lord. To the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from the God and Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Their eyes have seen. The text is Luke chapter 2, verse 30. For my eyes have seen your salvation. Here ends the text. Today is the first Sunday after Christmas, and since it's December 27th, it's also the day the church many centuries ago chose to remember St. John the Evangelist and Apostle. We have been introduced to Jesus, and we have come to believe in him because of the testimony that we have received through the written words of Scripture and the work of the Holy Spirit. Now, in the Scripture readings today, several individuals are mentioned who also were introduced to Jesus in a different way. They were introduced to Jesus directly, not through other people's testimonies and eyes, but their own. They knew about Jesus through what they saw and what they heard with their very own eyes and with their ears. The eyewitnesses mentioned in these verses include Joseph and Mary, Simeon, Anna, and St. John. They all saw Jesus with their own eyes. So, who are all these people? Joseph. In Matthew's gospel, Joseph's ancestors are traced back to King David. After contracting engagement to wed Mary, Joseph found himself with a very difficult situation. Mary was already pregnant. And Matthew 1:19 says, because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. However, an angel came to Joseph and told him that the child that Mary carried was conceived by the Holy Spirit. Joseph then took Mary as his wife. In the Gospel of Luke, Joseph traveled to Bethlehem with Mary from their hometown in Nazareth because of a government census that was being taken. There Jesus was born, and Joseph became the foster or stepfather of Jesus. Many centuries ago, the church decided to pick a day to honor Saint Joseph. March 19th was chosen for that day. Mary was well known as the virgin who was the mother of Jesus. According to Jewish customs of that time, Mary would have become a betrothed to Joseph when she was around 12 years old. After the betrothal and before the wedding, Mary was confronted with a very difficult situation. The situation would change her life. The angel Gabriel came and told Mary that she had found favor with God and that she would conceive and give birth to a son and was to call him Jesus. Mary asked the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And was told that the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Mary accompanied Joseph from Nazareth to Bethlehem. And when the time was right, after Jesus' birth, they took Jesus to Jerusalem, to the temple, for the designated religious rites following the birth of a firstborn son. That's where and when today's reading takes place. The day to commemorate Mary, the mother of our Lord, is August 15th. Then there's Anna. She was widowed at a young age and remained single. It was a very difficult challenge for a woman in those days. About all that we know about Anna beside that is contained in today's reading from Luke, where it says, two of those verses say, "There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Penuel of the tribe of Asher. She was very old. She had lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and then was a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped night and day, fasting and praying." Anna is remembered on September 1st. Simeon was also probably very old. And some of us also know the struggles of what that means, of getting older and dealing with the various things that come along with that. Simeon is introduced to us with these words in verses 25 and 26. "Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah." The day of remembrance for Simeon in the church is September 1st. St. John. Today is a day designated to commemorate St. John, apostle and evangelist. Unlike the first four mentioned, he did not see Jesus as an infant. John was one of the original 12 that were chosen to be Jesus' disciples. And he also went through a lot of difficult circumstances along with the other disciples and with Jesus. John is thought to have been the only one of the 12 to have not been, with the exception of Judas, of course, that John was not martyred for the faith in Jesus. According to traditions, not in the Bible, but other traditions, there was at least one attempt to martyr John. He was placed into a large pot of boiling oil. However, God miraculously saved him, like he did Daniel in the lion's den, and the three in the fiery furnace. John was the younger brother of James. James was another of the 12 disciples. Their father's name was Zebedee. Jesus referred to James and John as the sons of thunder. And when Jesus was dying on the cross, he asked John, who also was called the disciple whom Jesus loved, John was called on to care for Jesus' mother, Mary, after he was gone. John lived a long life and in his later years served as pastor of the church in Ephesus. And from there, he was exiled to the island of Patmos because of his faith in Jesus and because he was telling others about Jesus. It's thought that after some years, he returned to Ephesus, and that's where he passed away. The New Testament of John, the Gospel of John, the three epistles of John, and the book of Revelation, all were written by John. John wrote about seeing Jesus in the 1 John chapter 1. We have seen with our eyes, which we have looked at, and our hands have touched, and we proclaim to you eternal life, which was with the Father and has appeared to us. As God's people who believe in Jesus, these fabulous, faithful five believers all had several things in common. But the most notable one that we're noticing today is that they were all eyewitnesses of Jesus. Their eyes have seen Jesus, the Messiah. Jesus' foster father, Joseph, probably helped care for Jesus as a baby and probably watched him grow and watched him as Jesus worked with wood or metal because that was the family business that Joseph was in. Now, when Anna saw Jesus in the temple that day, verse 38, coming up to them at that very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. Mary, one of the songs that we sing at Christmas time, or listen to perhaps, asks the question, Mary, did you know? Yes, as a mother, as Jesus' mother, Mary knew lots and lots about Jesus. When he was about 30 years old, she also watched him turn water into wine. When people in the neighboring town said Jesus was doing crazy things and maybe was insane, she gathered some of Jesus' brothers and went herself to check on him. She also experienced the heartache of watching him die on the cross. The day that she was at the temple in Jerusalem and met Simeon, he had told her that Jesus would be great, but he also told Mary, a sword will pierce your soul also. That day, when Simeon saw the infant Jesus, he had said also that Jesus would be the salvation of Jews and Gentiles, and that he would reveal the truth that's hidden in the hearts of many, and that he would be spoken against, and that he would be responsible for many in Israel to rise and for others to fall, and that Jesus would bring glory to the people of Israel. In response, Jesus says his parents marveled at what was said about him. Simeon had also referred to Jesus as the consolation or the comfort of those who believe in him. He said, "For my eyes have seen your salvation." Simeon had lived so long because God had something to show him. God permitted him to see with his own eyes the Messiah. And when he had seen Jesus, he was ready to die. And he prayed that the Lord would now let him depart in peace according to his word. This tells us that as we live, we are to look for what God wants to show us. And then when we die, we also are to look for Jesus to show us our salvation. We consider Joseph, Mary, Anna, and St. John to be examples for us of how we should marvel at Jesus' first coming in Bethlehem. And with joy to honor him and to look for him for help and to serve him and to tell others about him. Let us also look forward to the Messiah's second coming with the same devout attention and dedication to Jesus that the faithful five saints mentioned today had. In conclusion, we are still in the Christmas season. Yesterday was the festival of St. Stephen's. You remember him, of course, as being the first martyr, someone who was selected among the leaders in Jerusalem to be somebody who would serve the widows and homeless and so forth and take care of them. So sometimes the St. Stephen's Day is also called Boxing Day, a day to give special gifts to those that are needing help. And today is another day for celebration. We can continue to celebrate the fact that God sent his Son to be born into this troubled world to be our Redeemer and our salvation. We can also remember Joseph, Mary, Simeon, and Anna and celebrate their lives as additional gifts. They were ordinary people coping with challenges and problems in life just like we do. And with their very eyes, they saw Jesus. They were eyewitnesses of him and saw his marvelous works of salvation. They're ordinary people, yet to them, God revealed his Son. They showed others then the amazing grace of God in Jesus so that others would know. Today, we also remember St. John, apostle and evangelist. We celebrate that he also saw Jesus with his own eyes and that he, with many words, wrote about what he witnessed. He communicated so that we, along with millions of others, could learn about Jesus and be brought to faith in him and have our faith increased in him and maintained. Their eyes have seen the salvation that we know. So we too can tell others as well what they saw and what they wrote and said. And the peace of God that transcends all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Continue with the prayer of the church. Please stand. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For grace to rejoice in Christ's blessed incarnation, in thankfulness that in the fullness of time God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem us and to give us adoption as your sons and heirs, and to grant us a glad new year. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For St. John, your holy evangelist, who has given to your church true testimony concerning Christ, we give you thanks. And for your spirit in the church and in our congregation, that we bear witness to the word of God, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For our nation and our world, that disease may be controlled and violence hindered, and for all those who make, administer, and judge our laws, that they may serve faithfully in their tasks according to your good pleasure for the benefit of our people. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the lonely, that they would be comforted with the sure and certain knowledge that God will never forsake them, and that within the household of faith, they might find family, friends, and loving companionship. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the sick and the suffering, especially Margie Carver, Mary Davis, Cindy Edwards, Leonard Hartman, Dylan Hetty, Anna Hoppe, Nancy Larimore, Judy Rodenbaugh's friend, Renee's friend, Sarah, Butch, and Sarah, and Susie, Charlotte, Crockett, and Laura Wilson, that according to God's gracious will, they would be healed, and for those who mourn, that God would fill their hearts with a certain hope of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those celebrating anniversaries this week, we ask that you provide for all their needs. Baptisms, Corey Newman and Tim Weaver, and birthdays, David Rodebaugh. Teach us, along with them, to be ever grateful for all your blessings and to show our gratitude with holy living. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who receive the Lord's Supper this day, that they would behold their salvation in the very body and blood of Christ, which is given for them, and with St. Simeon be well prepared to depart in peace according to God's word. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the good Lord bless and keep you. Make his face to shine on you. Make his grace be with you always. May his favor fill your days. May his peace and love enfold you. To our triune God be praise.